because he's an expert on Mayan history and culture. I've asked Dr. Bradley Russell to help me look for clues among the Mayapan ruins. Not only did people here fear the deadly snake god Kukulkan, they also built a monument to him in the very center of Mayapan.
Wow, look at that.
This is the Temple of Kukulkan. It's also called El Castillo, the castles. And it's a monument to the feathered serpent, to Kukulkan.
The largest temple in all of Mayapan was dedicated to the Kukulkan.
It's really the beating heart of Mayapan.
According to legend, Kukulkan, the feathered serpent god, gave mankind laws. The ruling families got their power from Kukulkan, who symbolized the divinity of the state and served as a messenger between the kings and the god. But like all Mayan gods, he required sacrifice.
So this is the sacrificial location.
This is. Essentially, they would be spread out backwards over the stone, and that would expose their chest so that they could get underneath the sternum and pull out the heart that way.
Here, like in public?
It's always public. But it's also really important to understand that they were a way for the state, or in this case, a particular lineage, to show their power to the people and to remind them who was in charge.
At this time, a great civil war was raging in Mayapan. The rulers used public sacrifices as a show of force and displayed bodies all over the city.
What story does this scene tell?
So this is an individual who's been decapitated. So you can see you have this niche. And when we excavated this, they found skull fragments and mandibles.
So this entire temple would have been covered with scenery of sacrifice.
Yes, absolutely.
Again, an obvious show of power from the Mayans here.
Right.
How long did Mayapan last?
Mayapan was around from 1100 to 1450.
350 years of death that ended with drought, war.
Rebellion. So this is the crematory.
Crematory as in people were cremated in here?
It was packed with burnt human bone all the way down to bedrock.
They burnt them here, they decapitated them there, they took their beating heart out of their body right there. It's quite brutal.
It is.
And very much a show of power.
If you want to assert your authority over a population, over an entire peninsula,
kill them in multiple different ways.
It's an effective way to do it.
None of these is anywhere close to the human remains that we found in the cenotes.
No, the Sakwayam collection looks very different.
Is that why you believe that the cenote human remains were not sacrificed?
Yeah, you just don't see the evidence for it there the way you do in other very clearly sacrificial deposits.
This city is pretty much just a big graveyard.
Literally is the graveyard.
If those bodies aren't sacrifices, then what are they doing in the cenotes? The cenotes provide water, so why would anyone dump bodies in the water source? A battle for power was raging. Could it have been an act of war to spoil the water on purpose? We know that disease and viruses contributed to the collapse of the Maya. Poison and other forms of biological warfare have been around for centuries. As far back as 590 BC, Athenians poisoned the water supply of their enemies. And during the Middle Ages, Genghis Khan used plague-infested bodies as weapon against his enemy. And if these cenotes are connected, contamination of water could have spread all over Mayapan. Is it possible that the plague that brought down the Maya was spread intentionally?
Bradley, I have a question.
Yeah?
Are the cenotes connected?
They're connected by water.
So all the cenotes are connected under the ground?
Yes.
This is what I'm thinking. What if those bodies inside Sakwayam were dumped there on purpose, deliberately, to poison the water as a part of the war?
I don't think the amount of contamination that you're dealing with in that situation would affect a city this size.
Unless there's more cenotes, similar to Sequoyum, hundreds of bodies that have been dumped there to poison the main water source for the whole city.
What we know about the history of Mayapan, it wasn't epidemic disease that drove the political disintegration of this city. Nobody knows the source of those diseases.
There's a possibility here that we're looking at one of the first recorded attempts of biological warfare in this region.
You are not going to believe what I found down here.
As Mayapan fell, warring factions violently tore each other apart. I believe that they also used biological warfare. And this confirms that my theory could be true.